Hello and welcome to My Carolina Today. I'm Alex Butler.
I'm Alana Cowboy. Coming up in today's show, we'll introduce you to the fitness programs at Fitness Connection. Yes, you're still working on those resolutions, right?
Get your workout on. Mm-hmm. Plus two experts who will help with love and finances. You know, those two go together.
Absolutely. And Valentine's Day spots and ideas in the triangle that you may not have thought of.
Date night.
Mm-mm. Yeah, and while we're talking about the people we love, our app of the week helps us pay less attention to the people we don't love.
That's right. It's called People Keeper, and it's an app that tracks, analyzes, and auto-manages your relationships. It uses a smartwatch, which is kind of interesting because it's like you, but I guess you can use like a heart rate monitor too.
Or you can do it without it.
Right.
The smartwatch allows the like watch
get,
to
get your heart rate,
yeah,
I guess,
for you, or you could just manually
do it yourself and say, oh, this person makes me uncomfortable. But yeah. I don't, I mean, Valanda, when I first told her about this, she was like, tell him what you said.
This is dumb.
She was like, this
Why
is dumb.
Why does anybody need an app to tell them how you feel about people? You
right.
know
You should just
you,
know. You
right.
know who you like. You know
but
who
in
you don't like.
In case you're not sure, People Keeper.
People Keeper.
Or if you just need something else to put on your phone.
Right, to add to the many apps that you already have. But this one, at least, it'll, you know, it's almost like Match.com Live or something, you know? Like, it's like you look down and you're like, oh, I like this person. Maybe I should talk to them longer. Some people need that. Blonda, you're social. Just saying. Okay, anyway, speaking of Valentine's Day.
Fayetteville is offering romantic carriage rides. If you've ever wanted to do that, Valentine's Day is the perfect time to do it. It's going down, of course, on Valentine's Day, Saturday, February 14th. Take a romantic horse-drawn carriage ride while you're downtown for dinner and a stroll.
Which sounds so nice.
It does. They're doing it all day, so you don't have to do it at night if you want to get your kids involved, maybe 1 to 8 p.m. on Saturday. And so it just sounds like a lot of fun to stroll through Fayetteville, Hay Street.
Have some fun.
Information there on your screen on how to book it in person or by phone.
Well, if you're still looking for an exciting date night, you might like this. You can actually enter to win a night 9,000 feet in the air. And this might not be for Valentine's Day, but take a look. That is basically, what do they call those things? It's like a, what do they call those things, Kim? What do they call them? It's like a gondola? Gondola. 9,000 feet above the air. There's a company called Airbnb that does all these destination travel stuff.
Yeah.
And basically they recreated or redesigned a gondola and turned it into like a night stay.
Oh.
And this is in France.
So spend the night in the gondola.
Yes. Erica's like, no. Would you think it was going to break and you're going to fall? Because it makes me nervous.
I would.
It makes me nervous. But basically, you can enter to win. You go to Airbnb.com. You tell them why, in 100 words or less, why you would want to stay there. And I think you can take up to 3 people with you. And there's like a gondola ride up to the thing. And then you get to stay there. But there's no TV.
You don't need TV. Valentine's night, day, whatever.
Yeah.
It looks cool.
It's cool. But yeah, 9,000 feet in the sky. If you're interested, you can search for a night in the sky.
Okay, you were asking me earlier today about my engagement photos.
Yes, because, you know, back in the day, I didn't know this, but like, not that far back in the day, Valanda, but like, you know, back in the day, other days before Facebook, mm-hmm. when you got engaged, there was no like, look at me, mm-hmm. put this out there. Mm-hmm. So now people try to outdo each other. It's keeping up with the Joneses. So this is a couple who wanted to really make a statement for their engagement. This is their save the date for their engagement photo. And the wife is holding a gun and her husband is hanging upside down from a tractor. Like, and it says the hunt is over at the bottom.
Oh.
Like she got him.
She got him. That's cute. Especially
cute.
If you know, hunt, if that's your thing.
All I could think of, if you look at the picture, if you actually see it online, his feet are actually tied into that thing. All I could think was how long he had to hang there to get the picture right.
Oh,
like
my.
With all that blood rushing to his head.
Yeah.
I mean, you know when you hang upside down?
That hurts.
Right? He probably was like, let's get this picture over with.
All right, so hopefully you watched us yesterday, and if you did, you noticed that we interviewed Natalie Bazile about her book, Queen Sugar. I sound like Regis Philbin. Oh, no. Anyway, just 2 hours after she was here, we found out the book is being turned into a series on OWN.
And Valanda had a conniption.
I did.
I'd never seen her get so crazy. Valanda moved the table like this. I can't believe she came on this show and didn't tell us that she was going to have a show made out of her book on Oprah. I was like, I saw the whole table shake, and I looked at Vlad. I was like, what's wrong? What's happening? All I heard was Oprah, because it was so catastrophic. I just heard Oprah. And then she was like, well, that girl, that lady, that woman. And so anyway, she went on to tell us that, you know, we found out after the fact
online. I had
online.
A straight up conniption.
Conniption.
Okay, so I wrote Natalie, and I congratulated her, and I expressed my disappointment that we didn't know, therefore we couldn't ask.
About
she
any
wrote
questions.
Back, quote, thank you, V. I wish we could have talked about it too, but this has all been under wraps for some time. Had no idea the official announcement was coming until this afternoon.
Which made us want to die. Because we could have asked her so many, I mean, we were
the one degree from Oprah yesterday.
Hello. I know what you're saying. We were very upset. We tried to get other people to be upset for us. We called producer
calling
Kim.
People like,
we were like, can you be mad
can
for
you
us?
Believe what just happened?
We were very upset.
Anyway, I'm over it. Thank
we're,
you,
we're
Natalie.
Moving on.
Her response was very gracious.
Yes, thank you. Oprah, thank you.
So Missy Elliott, of course, catapulted into the top 10 on iTunes Missy. After the Super Bowl. Can you believe this? Missy hasn't put out music since 2005.
And she's
okay?
huge now.
She performed with Katy Perry, as I'm sure you know, for Super Bowl halftime. We loved it, couldn't get enough, but she's got now 8 titles on the iTunes Top 200
Which is amazing.
Songs chart. People were just, oh, Missy, let me go get that.
Brought her back. Brought Missy back.
Okay, but Twitter cracked me up. Take a look at what some people posted on Twitter. Quote, who is this Missy Elliott? Katy Perry is about to make her famous.
That's because people didn't know, Lalonda.
Here's
we're from the generation
one.
That knew.
Katy Perry is going to make this Missy Elliott girl blow up. Can you believe this? And here's what Missy had to say. The new kids think I'm a new artist and I'm about to blow up like Paul McCartney. Lord have mercy, child. I love me some y'all. And then Missy also wrote, I think it's cool. New kids think I'm a new artist. That goes to show you that I'm still on fire and will rip down stages 20 years later.
Snaps from Erica. Snaps from Erica
we
in the back.
We love some Missy Elliott up ooh, in ooh. Here.
Yeah, I'm
that
loving it.
That just cracked me up.
Well, go Missy and welcome back. I
yes.
was loving it. All right,
now
what
give
are
you? Some more music. More yeah, music, Missy. More.
Yeah, more.